just like a foreign city in the midst of America, is New Orleans. Of another world are its Mardis Gras, its river levees, its picturesque alleys, its easygoing, peaceful life. And this old world city, in fact, the entire state of Louisiana, is in the grip of a decidedly un-American dictatorship of the loudest character the national political scene has heard in a generation. Long is the name, and long is the way this unusual man has come in the last 7 years. A year later, he was impeached by Louisiana's House of Representatives on 19 assorted charges, from corruption to gross misconduct. But he already controlled the state Senate, and he wriggled out of the impeachment to become a minor national figure, rowdy and vivid. From 1928 on, his doings are news. When the German cruiser Emden visits New Orleans, its commander calls formally on Louisiana's governor. Huey Long's informal reception brings a demand for an official apology. Next day, in dress clothes borrowed piece by piece from friends, he returns the call and receives the governor's salute. Frankly a demagogue, he had been elected through his appeal to the people up the bayou. He promised and he gave them new roads, free bridges instead of toll bridges, a new state capitol, and to himself a new governor's mansion, upping the state's debt 300%, but giving jobs to thousands who will vote for Huey Long. Great fun has the self-styled kingfish in running Louisiana. With rare self-consciousness, he accepts an honorary doctorate of laws from Loyola University. His pretty typist, he makes Secretary of State and lets her run Louisiana when he is away.
As the First Lady Governor of Louisiana, I want to take this opportunity to thank my many friends for...
In 1932, Huey Long has himself elected to the United States Senate.
I'm very proud to be here tonight and know this is the proudest moment of my whole career.
Well, it's been a great evening.
Says the newly elected senator, I've done all I can for Louisiana. Now I want to help the rest of the country. Louisiana's kingfish graduates to the national political stage, is greeted in Washington by Democratic Senate leader Joseph D. Robinson.
Thank you, Senator Robinson. I'm certainly glad to be with you.
To run his state, Dictator Long puts in O.K. Allen, his good-natured henchman, now puppet governor of Louisiana.
Oscar Kelly Allen.
To his new friends in Washington, Huey boasts that back in Louisiana, he has the best legislature money can buy.